YouTube, what's going on? T. Davis back again here. Week 8 of the NFL season. We are about halfway through the NFL season. Well, actually, no. We have 18 weeks now, so we're a little bit less than halfway. But, man, it's gone by fast. It's been a lot of fun. Had a great season so far. We had some great profits. We're going to break down the best picks for Week 8 on DraftKings and Fanduel. Of course, we will base it off of DraftKings, but I will head over to Fanduel and, you know, point out a couple picks that really stand out as far as value goes over there. And we'll kind of break through each position, all the plays, whether it be studs, kind of mid-range guys, and value. So if you guys want more content like this, make sure to go ahead and smash that like button on this video. Subscribe to the channel for more fantasy football, daily fantasy, and pro Madden player content. Of course, comment down below if you guys think I missed anyone as well. If you think anyone stands out, of course, we're recording this on Thursday, so there is a few days here where we could find out some more injury news. So just be aware of the news, of course, leading up to Sunday. But as far as Thursday goes, this is what we're gonna kind of break down here on the channel. Of course, check out ThriveFantasy.com. I have a great partnership with them. If you use that code TDavis at when you deposit, you will get a 100% deposit match. So you put in $100, you'll get another $100 in your account, equaling $200 in your account. So 100% deposit bonus up to $100. Use that code TDavis at ThriveFantasy.com. So let's get into it here. We won't waste no more time. We'll start on DraftKings here. Start the quarterback position, starting off with Josh Allen. If you have the money to afford him, guy's an absolute stud, man. We all thought going into the year, you know, Miami would have a pretty decent defense, but they've been exploitable, man. They really have. They have two good corners, but the way that this Buffalo passing game works, I mean, the volume is just there for Josh Allen, regardless of matchup. The matchup literally doesn't matter when you have Josh Allen. This guy is an absolute stud. They're going to pass the ball at least 40 times a game, and I don't expect that to be any different here. Now, I will say the price is a little steep, so we might be able to find some guys, you know, a little bit cheaper. But if you do have the money, Josh Allen is an absolute standout play here. You can pair him up with Stephon Diggs. You can pair him up with even Cole Beasley. You can do a little double stack with maybe Manny Sanders and Beasley, or Sanders and Diggs. You can afford two of these guys at receiver. So I think Josh Allen really stands out here as the top overall quarterback as far as, you know, just from a raw point projection basis. If you have that salary, definitely worth it. FanDuel, I think he's even better because I do think Josh Allen has at least a 2-touchdown floor, and maybe, you know, he has 5-6 touchdown upside. So FanDuel, where touchdowns are even more important, I do prefer him over there, especially because some of the guys below him, they're just priced so close to him on FanDuel that you can get to him. Stafford, absolute money going up against Houston. Now, this should be a blowout here against Houston, and Darrell Henderson's going to be very popular at running back, which we'll get to. But if you want leverage off of Darrell Henderson, I think Stafford is a guy you can easily go to, because look, if the Rams are going to score points, and it might be through the air. What it's kind of been all year is Stafford throwing the ball. This guy has 19 touchdowns already through 7 weeks. He loves to throw the ball with Cooper Kupp and Robert Woods and Van Jefferson. So Stafford, you can get that direct leverage off of the higher-owned Darrell Henderson, and they love to throw the ball in the air. He's thrown for 4 touchdowns multiple times this year. Stafford, an absolute slam-dunk play here on the road against a bad Houston team. Tom Brady, always in play. I think New Orleans' defense is pretty good, so I will probably be off him. But Tom Brady always has that upside, especially on FanDuel, where touchdowns are so important, and Tom Brady can throw for easily, can throw for 5 touchdowns. He's one of the best plays on FanDuel every single week. So Tom Brady, more of a FanDuel play for me. I won't be playing him on DraftKings without that rushing upside. Keep it moving down here. Jalen Hurts, he's been priced up a lot now, but a slam dunk matchup against Detroit. This guy is the garbage time king, as I like to call him. Every time, it seems like the fourth quarter, Jalen Hurts, they're usually trailing, and he just turns it on in the fourth quarter, getting some garbage touchdowns. He has that rushing upside, which we absolutely love from a fantasy perspective. He's priced up really high on FanDuel, so I think on FanDuel you just easily go up to Josh Allen, which we'll get to in a second. But on DraftKings, I love this price tag for Jalen Hurts at 7,200. I think he's going to be very popular as well. Joe Burrow, another great spot here against the Jets. Direct leverage off of Joe Mixon. They're going to score a lot of touchdowns in this matchup. The 5-2 number one seed Cincinnati Bengals, and if they're going to score touchdowns, it might be through Joe Burrow. This guy's an absolute stud. You compare him with Ja'Marr Chase, his favorite weapon. Compare him with T. Higgins, maybe even Tyler Boyd, maybe even the tight end, who we'll get to, C.J. Uzomah. But they're going to score points. Joe Burrow is a direct source to do that. So I love Joe Burrow. I think it's a good price, too, here at 7,100. Now, we'll move down to a couple of the cheaper guys that I really like this week. Matt Ryan here going up against Carolina. Carolina's kind of falling apart now as we head to the midway part of the season. And Matt Ryan has really picked it up. You see the last 3 weeks, over 20 fantasy points. He's really starting to play much better, getting into a groove, especially with Kyle Pitts, who we will get to. But you got Kyle Pitts and Ridley, and you can actually afford that double stack this week with Kyle Pitts and Calvin Ridley. You can maybe even throw, you can do Cordarrelle Patterson instead if you want. But Ryan has some weapons now at his disposal. I think that's a game that they can win in the dome, too. We always love to target games in the dome for that high-scoring upside. Carson Wentz here going up against Tennessee. I think they'll try to slow down Jonathan Taylor. And Carson Wentz has really picked it up last couple weeks, man. He's looked good. 11 touchdowns, only one interception this year. So he's not really turning the ball over. His last four games, he has two touchdowns. I think Carson Wentz is in a good spot here at a cheap price tag. $5,700, you can pair him with Michael Pittman. Love that price tag for him. Any other guys I'll mention here I like? Where is he? Teddy Bridgewater here down at $5,400. The Washington football team, definitely a defense you want to attack through the air. They have a good pass rush, but they're not going to be able to run the ball against Washington with that front set, that front four, great defensive line. So they're going to have to pass the ball through the air. $5,400, very decreased price tag here for Teddy. And you don't need much out of him at this price tag. He can get you to that 20 fantasy points, and that's really all you would need. You can pair him with the returning Jerry Jeudy. You can pair him with Cortland Sutton, maybe even Noah Fant. So I think Bridgewater is a cheap option here that we can get to. Love that as well in this matchup. Then the only other guy that I'll mention, and it's one of my favorite plays of the week, believe it or not, is Jared Goff here for Detroit. I know Detroit is terrible. They haven't won a game. Jared Goff has been atrocious. But going up against a bad Philadelphia secondary at home in the arena in Detroit, I think this game is one of the stacks of the week, right? I think this game has a lot of scoring upside here. And I'll be targeting Jared Goff a lot. And I think at $5,200, you can get away with that price tag easily. Pair him with, I don't know who you pair him with. You could honestly even pair him with DeAndre Swift because he catches so many balls. But you can pair him with TJ Hawkinson easily. St. Brown, who we'll get to, is a cheap option. But I like Jared Goff here. Then you, if you play Jared Goff, you can pay up for some studs at running back and receiver as well. So I think he's in play here. As far as FanDuel goes, I think Josh Allen is the clear-cut best play here. He's only 400 more than Jalen Hurts, so I think for me, I'm playing Josh Allen at 8,800. But a couple of the cheap guys that I will mention that I think have great price tags are Matt Ryan here. Only 7,200 on FanDuel. That is a great price tag for him. And then, of course, the guy that I just mentioned, Jared Goff, only at 6,800 down here. I think that's a good price tag as well if you do want to pay down a quarterback. But I don't really think we need to. The pricing on FanDuel is relatively soft. So I think you can get up to a guy like Josh Allen. So we'll go over to the running back position here. All starts with the big dog, King Henry, Derrick Henry, going up against the Colts. I'm not super afraid of the Colts defense. I know they're going to do a lot to try to slow down the Titans' running attack, but Derrick Henry is just an outlier, man. This guy is just an absolute beast. He's getting a couple targets out of the backfield, too. The problem is $8,900. Do we pay that price tag? I think it's reasonable. I think we can. And especially them not having Julio Jones this week, they're going to have to give the ball to the big dog a little bit more. So Derrick Henry, probably the best pay-up option here at running back. Austin Eckler going up against the Patriots. I know he's a little banged up, but a high-scoring game here against the Patriots in the afternoon slate. It's one of the highest-scoring games of the week. We have to monitor the news leading up to Sunday, but I do think Eckler will play, and he's definitely in play here. Now, Najee Harris, all year I've been riding him, right? I've been playing Najee Harris. He's in that Le'Veon Bell role, and he just was not priced up. He was staying in those mid 6K ranges, and now they finally moved him up to 7,500. And I'm still not sure if that's enough for Najee Harris in that Le'Veon Bell old, you know, the role that Le'Veon Bell used to play for the Steelers. Going up against Cleveland, they have a pretty good defense, but Ben Roethlisberger, he just targets this guy all game long. Ben Roethlisberger can't really throw the ball down the field. Plus, you lose a guy like Juju Smith-Schuster. Receivers are kind of banged up. He's going to look to Najee Harris a lot. And on DraftKings specifically, you want a lot of targets. You want a lot of receptions from your running backs. Absolutely love Najee Harris here against Cleveland. Joe Mixon up against the Jets, not much to say there. They're going to be huge, huge favorites here. You're going to think they're going to feed Joe Mixon, especially in the second half. When they have the lead, they can wind that clock. Joe Mixon, one of the best plays on this entire slate. DeAndre Swift, I forgot to mention right here, 7,100. Absolutely love him against the Eagles. I think this is a game Detroit can win. And so game script might be in their favor. They might have the lead, and they'll hand the ball more to him. But just look at the targets, 10, 7, 6, 6, 7. This guy is an absolute weapon, especially on DraftKings, where we love those receptions. He's an absolute slam dunk play on DraftKings every week because of the volume he gets in the passing game. So DeAndre Swift at 7,100, just an amazing play this week. Like I said about Mixon, Darrell Henderson, probably the highest owned player this week. He was last week. Didn't really perform up to his potential last week, but he still got six targets. You love to see that. Going up against a bad Houston defense, they should control this game again as well. They kind of got up last week. They kind of, you know, started off bad against the Lions and were trailing, but they should control the game from start to finish against Houston. Darrell Henderson should be in control and handle a lot of the carries in this matchup. He's going to be one of the highest owned. Should be priced up way higher than 6,500. So he's going to be the highest owned cash game lock right there. Leonard Fournette, a great pivot off of Henderson. He's getting the carries. He's getting the volume in the passing game as well. You see 4, 6, 5, 5 for targets the last 4 weeks. Against New Orleans, pretty good defense, but I think this is a matchup that Tampa Bay can win. Obviously, they are the favorites, and Fournette should get a good amount of carries. He should get some the goal line carries as well. So Fournette, really love him this week. He's a great pivot, like I said, off of Henderson at that 6,300 price tag. Chuba Hubbard here, he's been the workhorse since Christian McCaffrey's gone out. He's getting some targets out of the backfield as well, which we'd love to see. Good matchup against the Falcons as well. The Falcons have historically gave up, you know, targets to the running back position. So I think Chuba Hubbard at 6K is a great price tag here. He's a relatively safe play as well. He's getting a pretty good amount of the work here for the Panthers. A couple other cheap options that I will mention here on DraftKings is Kenneth Gainwell. I don't love it, but the price tag is just so nice for the passing game role that he has. No Miles Sanders. They're saying that Jordan Howard might be the starter. He's just a first and second down back. Gainwell should be out there for most of the third downs. They use him at receiver some. So 5K on DraftKings, I think, is an absolute slam dunk play. I don't really like him on FanDuel because, you know, receptions don't really matter as much on FanDuel. They're way more important on DraftKings. So Gainwell at 5K in a great matchup on DraftKings is one of the best plays of the slate, in my opinion. And then on FanDuel, the only one that I'll mention, of course, all these guys are very viable here. Derrick Henry, of course, is in play on FanDuel. I love Joe Mixon here on FanDuel at only 7,600. Chuba Hubbard, who we mentioned, only at 6,600 is a slam dunk play on FanDuel. But the one guy that I didn't mention on DraftKings that I do like on FanDuel, if I can find him here, is... Where is he? Might have to type him in here in a second. Nope, there he is. Eli Mitchell at 5,800 here on FanDuel. That is an extremely low price tag. He is the guy in that San Francisco 49ers backfield. I know Chicago is a pretty good defense, but at 5,800, this is a game that San Francisco can win. I know it's a low total, too. So I think San Francisco, they don't trust their quarterback position. They're going to hand the ball a lot off to Eli Mitchell. And if he gets you a rushing touchdown, and even if he only gets you 60, 70 yards rushing and a touchdown, he's going to pay off his $5,800 salary, and it allows you to pay up at other spots. So I think Eli Mitchell is very interesting over there on FanDuel as well. Move over to the receiver spot. There's so many good receiver plays this week. I'll kind of go through them quickly because, you know, it's kind of a pick and choose. We'll talk about some of the studs, but we'll break down the values a little bit more. Cooper Kupp. Listen, I don't need to say anything. Cooper Kupp is the best player in fantasy football this year. He's priced up at 9K now, going up against Houston. I don't need to say anything, man. Cooper Kupp, if you can afford him, slam dunk play. Pair him with Stafford. Keep it moving. Jamar Chase here against the Jets. Don't need to say much about him. He's looking like a top five receiver. Dude's just an absolute monster. Has a great connection with Joe Burrow. Might win the rookie of the year at the receiver position, which is wild. But 7,500, he should be an 8K receiver. So we can definitely attack Jamar Chase here. DJ Moore going up against the Falcons. We talked about the Falcons' defense not being good. This should be one of the highest scoring games on the slate as well. DJ Moore, 7,200. Great play here. AJ Brown. Julio Jones was just ruled out. That makes AJ Brown the number one receiver by far here. They're going to have to look to him for targets here. No Julio Jones. So AJ Brown might be one of the better plays on the slate here. Only 6,900. Into my opinion, he's like a 7,500 plus receiver as well, so you're getting a discount there. Calvin Ridley. I know the whole talk in the fantasy football community has been about Calvin Ridley. His A dot is down this year. He's not running deep. What is going on with Calvin Ridley? But I'm a guy that wants to bet on talent here. He has a rapport with Matt Ryan. You got to think they want to get him going. 6,600, man. That just seems like a criminal price for Calvin Ridley. I mean, this guy was 7,900 to start the year. He was supposed to be one of the best receivers in football this year. Obviously, he has not paid off for what people were drafting him in season longs. But I still want to bet on the talent and a great matchup. Give me Calvin Ridley, man. 6,600. I'll be slam dunking that lock button there. Keenan Allen, not a bad play against the Patriots. High scoring game. I have a lot of respect for the Patriots defense, obviously, as a Patriots fan. But Keenan Allen at 6,500, that's a good price tag in a high-scoring environment. Chris Godwin, Antonio Brown is out again. Chris Godwin kind of takes over that default slot role, went absolutely bonkers last week against the Bears. He can do it again here with no Antonio Brown. Godwin, one of the best players on the slate. Robert Woods here in this mid-range. This mid-range is a great area to attack. Robert Woods, if you're not going to play Cup, then definitely play Woods. Doesn't have the upside that Cup has, but he's still a great, solid receiver here. Where we got Devontae Smith now, 5,500. We talked about this Eagles-Lions game a ton, how I absolutely love this game for GPP purposes, how we can stack it. So Devontae Smith, I think, is great at 5,500. He's even better on Fanduel, which we'll get to. You can play any of these Bills receivers you want. Diggs, Sanders, Beasley, talked about them. Love all of them as well. Michael Pittman Jr., I think, is a slam dunk play here. No T.Y. Hilton again, I believe, this week. So Michael Pittman's been the number one receiver. Tennessee's a defense you can easily attack here. And they're going to try to slow down Jonathan Taylor. So they do that. You're going to get Wentz to Pittman a lot for a great connection. T. Higgins, we talked about the Bengals destroying the Jets. If they're not going to go to Jamar Chase, they're probably going to go to Higgins. Great price tag at 5,200. Keep it moving down here. Let's talk about some of the value guys that I'm really interested here. Jerry Jeudy, if he is activated off IR, I'm not sure if he will be. But if he is, a great price tag here at 4,900. He's only played one game this year, and he looked good in that week one matchup till he got hurt. And Washington, like I said, is a defense that you tack through the air. So I do like Jerry Jeudy there. Tyler Boyd, we talked about the Bengals. If you're not going to play Chase, you're not going to play Higgins, then play Tyler Boyd. I know his A-dot is low, so he needs a lot of volume to do good. But 4,800, good price tag. Robbie Anderson, oh man, the disappointment of the year. I don't know what to say about him. He's getting the targets. Like, look, 9 targets, 11 targets, 7 targets, 11 targets, and a great matchup against the Falcons in a dome. Like, if there's ever a week that we're going to finally play Robbie Anderson, it's this week at only 4,700 in the best matchup that he's seen all year. And he's getting the targets, man. I don't know what to say. It's hard to ignore him there at 4,700. Odell Beckham, this seems wild that his price has dropped to 4,600, but I'm just not sure if Odell Beckham is that elite anymore. He's listed questionable, so we got to monitor that news. But if you would have told me, like, any time in my life that Odell Beckham would be 4,600 on DraftKings, I would just slam dunk that play all the time. So I don't know. It's hard to ignore Odell Beckham here at 4,600. Like, I want to play him a lot, and I'm probably going to. So we'll see how that kind of shakes out if he plays, if he's not ruled out. And the only other guy that I'll mention is Laviska Shenault here. Don't love it, but he's definitely in play under 5K here. 4,700, not a bad price tag. I think the Jaguars can win that game, too, against the Seahawks. So he'd be a guy that I would go to as well. So that's kind of how the cheap guys pan out. Receiver on FanDuel, of course, the studs are all in play. Cup, Chase, DJ Moore, Stephon Diggs. Stephon Diggs has a relatively low price tag here at 7,300, which I will attack as well. Chris Godwin, of course, we mentioned. Calvin Ridley seems very underpriced here on FanDuel as well, 7K. And a couple other guys, Devontae Smith down here, I think is a great price tag, 6,200. I'll be playing him a lot over here on FanDuel, and then the only other guy that I'll mention is T. Higgins there at 6,300. So I'm kind of leaning towards this mid-range on FanDuel and then maybe one of these studs. I don't think you really need to go cheap because the pricing is much softer on FanDuel. So now tight end, we'll kind of wrap it up here with Kyle Pitts. Of course, this guy, I told you guys all season long, man, I'm going back to the well with Kyle Pitts. It paid off the last 2 weeks. This guy's an absolute stud. He's pretty much their number one receiver, too. He's running deep routes. He's running short routes. He's doing it all for the Falcons. Ryan really starting to go to him. And 6,300, obviously, is a very elevated price tag, but I love Kyle Pitts. If you can afford him, he's going to be very low-owned, and he's a great stud to pay up for. TJ Hockenson, we talked about this matchup a lot. I love it to pair it with Goff. You can get tons of leverage off of DeAndre Swift there. TJ Hockenson, love that price tag. I'll take him a lot for a stud. Noah Fant, talked about the Washington football team secondary being bad. Noah Fant, I like him to pair with Bridgewater for a great stack. Dallas Goedert, one of the best players on the slate this week by far in that same matchup. And he's even better on FanDuel. So I'll be attacking Dallas Goedert a lot. He's probably my lock on FanDuel, to be honest. Tyler Higbee, definitely in play every week for that Rams high-powered offense. Got 8 targets last week. Continues to get targets, just hasn't had the touchdown volume that we'd like to see. But Higbee's always in play, man. He's never priced too high either. Ricky Seals-Jones, he's done a great job replacing Logan Thomas. Great athletic profile. So we'll monitor to see when Logan Thomas comes back off IR. I'm not sure when he will be. But until then, we can keep attacking Ricky Seals-Jones here, getting the volume. Now, CJ Uzuma is so interesting. This guy is a beast at touchdowns. He just doesn't get the volume we want to see. He had that big run last week. I'll still go there. I think he is, obviously, it's risky, but at 3,700, man, if he gets you one touchdown, he pays it off. And he's been getting touchdowns all year long. So it's hard to ignore CJ Uzuma here, even though he's not getting the targets that we want. So I think that's a guy you can punt with. Jared Cook here, another guy we can punt with. High-scoring game against the Patriots. He hasn't produced that great, but at 3,400, you don't need much from him. So that's a guy that I'll look at. Then the other two cheap guys that we can punt with, Cole Kmet here, 3,100. Looked pretty good last week. Six targets, 43 yards at that price tag. That's all you need. Low-scoring matchup, of course, but I think he can get you there at only 3,100. And then probably the highest owned player on the slate, Dan Arnold here at 2,800, near min price for the Jacksonville Jaguars. This guy is an athletic freak as well, former receiver. So I think he'll be very popular here. You can punt your tight end spot at 2,800, especially in cash games, a great spot to go to. And then on FanDuel, only thing I'll mention here that I like, I think Kyle Pitts, of course, in play, but I think Dallas Goedert here is the absolute lock on FanDuel tight end. Like, I'm just going to lock him in now because that price tag, $5,900 for the volume, for the matchup, everything goes in Dallas Goedert's favor here. I'm going to slam dunk that play on FanDuel. So that's pretty much it for this slate, guys. Week 8 coming soon. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Of course, like I said, hit that like button, comment down below, subscribe to the channel. We will be back with the Sunday night and Monday night football showdowns. Appreciate the support, man. Until next time, peace.